Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. The highly anticipated inaugural cargo flight of Sierra Space's Dream Chaser spaceplane has been delayed yet again, now scheduled for no earlier than May 2025. This postponement shifts the launch date from an earlier target of late 2023, raising questions about the complexities and challenges faced by Sierra Space in its ambitious efforts to establish a new era of in-space logistics and infrastructure. Despite these delays, the company is pressing forward with a second cargo spaceplane, Reverence, alongside the development of inflatable habitats and other innovative projects aimed at meeting the growing demand for orbital infrastructure. The inaugural mission, featuring the spaceplane Tenacity, will deliver cargo to the International Space Station, ISS, under NASA's Commercial Resupply Services 2 CRS-2 contract. This mission will mark a significant milestone for Sierra Space, as Tenacity is set to launch aboard United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur rocket from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Currently housed at Kennedy, Tenacity has undergone rigorous environmental testing to prepare for its maiden voyage. However, the delay has drawn attention to the intricate processes behind the Dream Chaser program. According to Sierra Space spokesperson Alex Walker, the revised timeline reflects the company's commitment to safety and reliability. Walker also confirmed that work on Reverence, also known as DC-102, will resume once the team returns to Sierra Space's Colorado facility. Still, with an estimated 18-month timeline for completing the second space plane, the gap between Tenacity's debut and Reverence's readiness may be significant. Sierra Space's Dream Chaser program encompasses more than just cargo missions. The company is simultaneously developing a crewed variant, the DC-200 series, and a national security-focused DC-300 version. Each Dream Chaser spaceplane is designed for a lifespan of 15 missions, providing flexibility for diverse applications. Reverence will effectively double our capacity, giving us 30 missions for different customers, said Angie Wise, Sierra Space's Chief Safety Officer and Senior Vice President for Mission Assurance. Supporting these missions are Shooting Star cargo modules, which attach to the Dream Chaser to transport scientific equipment, food, and other supplies to the ISS. Once berthed to the station using a robotic arm, the Shooting Star modules allow crew members to access cargo via the spaceplane's aft hatch. The first Shooting Star module, which will accompany Tenacity on its inaugural flight, has undergone extensive testing to ensure its readiness for the rigors of space travel. To ensure mission success, Sierra Space has established a state-of-the-art mission control center adjacent to its factory floor. This facility, equipped with live feeds from NASA's Johnson Space Center, will manage Dream Chaser operations with a team of approximately a dozen personnel. The mission control team is undergoing intensive training, including simulated flights and joint exercises with NASA and United Launch Alliance. We are conducting rigorous simulations to prepare our team for every conceivable scenario, said Wise. Once they feel confident in their abilities, we'll introduce simulated failures and high-stress situations to test their resilience. The worst day in this control room should always be a simulation. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. This methodical approach underscores Sierra Space's commitment to ensuring that every aspect of the Dream Chaser program is meticulously tested before the first operational flight. Beyond the Dream Chaser program, Sierra Space is pioneering the development of inflatable habitats, a critical component of its vision for a sustainable space infrastructure. The large integrated flexible environment, life habitat, represents a cornerstone of this effort. Using Vectron, a high-performance liquid crystal polymer fiber that is stronger than steel when inflated, the life habitat is designed to provide a spacious and adaptable environment for astronauts. the company has already tested two full-scale inflatable structures and six smaller prototypes, gathering valuable data to refine its designs. A three-story model of the life habitat, featuring 285 cubic meters of volume, stands on the factory floor as a testament to Sierra Space's progress. Outfitted with a semi-metallic core, wall separators, and a newly installed window, this prototype demonstrates the potential for comfortable and functional living spaces in orbit. Sierra Space envisions future versions of the life habitat expanding to over 70 feet in length and 62 feet in diameter, offering up to 5,000 cubic meters of usable volume. To achieve this, the company is conducting extensive testing to evaluate the material's performance under various conditions, including impacts from micrometeoroids and orbital debris. At NASA's White Sands Test Facility in New Mexico, Sierra Space engineers are subjecting the life habitat materials to rigorous testing. Using gas guns, they bombard stacked layers of material with projectiles at hypervelocity speeds to simulate the harsh conditions of space. This testing not only assesses the material's ability to withstand impacts, but also evaluates its radiation protection capabilities. It's essential to understand how these materials work together as an integrated system, explained Elizabeth Licavoli, a senior systems engineer leading the soft goods certification and testing efforts. The data we collect gives us confidence that these materials will perform well in orbit. Sierra Space's ambitions extend beyond the ISS. The company is developing a free-flying version of the Shooting Star cargo module, which could serve as an independent satellite for housing payloads in orbit. This platform, equipped with a deployable decelerator known as Sierra Space Ghost, is designed to return cargo safely to Earth. Additionally, Sierra Space is working under a Space Act agreement awarded by NASA in 2023 to explore new commercial space station architectures. This initiative includes developing in-space logistics, refueling, and servicing systems, further solidifying the company's role as a leader in orbital infrastructure. Despite the challenges and delays, Sierra Space remains steadfast in its mission to revolutionize space exploration and commerce. The Dream Chaser spaceplane, with its versatile design and broad range of applications, represents a critical step toward achieving this vision. Coupled with the development of inflatable habitats and innovative cargo solutions, Sierra Space is positioning itself as a key player in the burgeoning space economy. As the countdown to Tenacity's inaugural flight continues, the company's meticulous approach to testing and preparation reflects its commitment to safety, reliability, and innovation. While the delays may be frustrating for space enthusiasts, they underscore the complexities of advancing human capabilities in space. With each test and simulation, Sierra Space moves closer to realizing its ambitious goals, proving that patience and perseverance are essential in the pursuit of groundbreaking achievements. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.